Hi, patrons. It's Rob. This is a very weird three beer Thursday that I'm doing. I'm actually in Tochigi, but today I've got three different beers on the go from West Coast Brewing. I've got the Full Metal Alchemist, which is an 8% hazy double IPA. Never Enough Base, which is a 5.5% hazy pale ale. And finally, one of my favourites actually from them is the Hop Wave. Again, it's an 8%, but this time it's a West Coast double IPA. So I know I haven't done one of these videos for a while. It's just going to be a very rough and muddy one. I'm using my phone. Couldn't find my phone charger, so I had to use a random cable I found somewhere, and I couldn't find my camera battery charger. Don't know where the hell that's gone. So join me as I sit in Woodsman's Village in Tochigi, as I sit and drink these three beers, with the first one being this. So first up, as I said, is this. Can't see there. Full Metal Alchemist. It's 8% double IPA. I do apologise if my kids doesn't run in because we're here as a quick break. But very orange, hazy colour, pure white head on top. Sticking around for quite a while actually. Ooh, dank hops. Ooh, woody, very woody hops going on there. When I say woody, it's kind of like a oaky flavour, not a grassy woody flavour, but big, boozy, kind of a slight whiskey barrel aged hop profile. I guess it's one of those HBC ones. I'm sure I'll add on some subtitles later about what hop I think it is. I just can't remember for the life of me. I know George at TDM 1874 gave me a little small bag of their hops and was like, use this for a stout. I didn't. I forgot. Ooh, slight phenolic. Packs and punch. I'll give you that. I'm going to drink this because I've been driving for about 4 hours. And I'll drink these two in a bit. This is the second in the West Coast Brewing video. As you can see, I've still got the can in the first part, which is the Four Hop Alchemist. Next up is going to be the Never Enough Base. This is a hazy pale ale that contains lactose, kind of to be expected really. And you probably can't see it. Also, I know you can't see it because it's in the top, but it's a very, very light colour straight away. It's kind of like a, I hate to say it, but a very pale yellow colour. Very fruity, lots of mosaic, peaches, grapefruit. Very full on fruity. Quite tart bitterness to start off with. Pineapple, grapefruit. There's something underlying there. It's definitely creamy, I want to say. This beer was actually part of a collaboration with the Slop Shop in Tokyo. They had some cans, this is the basic design, but they had some cans that had some special labels on for their 1 year anniversary, which was a couple weeks ago actually. Still not been there yet. Money because they refuse to put prices on their pictures on the ones they upload. But going back to this beer, I mean, it's a pale ale. A little bit hoppier, hazy. I mean, I'm starting to hate that word hazy because a lot of the time it seems to be that breweries just go, we're not gonna filter this beer. It's a hazy. But it's quite full-bodied. Again, that could be because of the haziness in there, the proteins. Boy, this is the kitchen of the log cabin. That Ebis just there. It's not mine, it's my wife's. She did some driving today because I had enough basically.
and we tend to drink after we've done some dry rum. Not before. Very important. After. But cheers, I'm going to finish this off. Hopefully, I might get one more beer in today. I don't know, I'm on cooking duty, and as you can see, I had to change clothes from yesterday. But, cheers.
Hey, day three here in Tochigi. As you can see, it's changed. I did say to you it's going to be a very different three beer Thursday. It's been a very weird couple of days here. We're in Okoragawa, a village of about 8,000 people. We were just walking down that way earlier, and we bumped into a couple of people in the air, and they said the local elementary school used to have 400 people. They're down to about 20. Very, very weird. But I said, last one in the series, it's the Hop Wave. There you go. It's an 8% West Coast double IPA. Little backstory. Michael, in Q&A number 7, asked me about what beers I liked and which I liked first, beer or Japan. I mentioned it was beer. But actually, this was one of the very first, actually, not this beer, but one of the very first styles of non-English IPA I had was a West Coast double IPA by Green Flash. And if you remember, they actually have kind of the copyright on the style. But that was the first non-English IPA I had, and in all honesty, it kind of just blew me away. I was thinking, what the hell is going on here? This is a beer that's bitter, it's lemony, it's citrus, it's dank. And I fell in love with it after about 6 bottles. And as you can see, it is kind of caramelly. It looks a bit dark brown. And it smells beautiful. It smells dank, resinous.
Yeah.
A slight alcohol heat in the back. This has been warming up for a bit. It's definitely a West Coast. Ironically, because it is West Coast, and it is a West Coast IPA. But there's a weird, it's maybe the resininess lasts for perhaps a bit too long, but I have to say, I had the Full Hop Alchemist on the Thursday, it's now Saturday. I had the Never Enough Base on the Friday, and it's Saturday, and I've had this. And I have to say, out of the three, this is definitely my favourite. Maybe perhaps because, like I said, I'm partial to West Coast IPAs. I've grown to like hazy doubles. This pale ale, it wasn't bad. Like I said in part two, it was drinkable, it was nice. It had, if I looked for a pale ale, but it just didn't take things further. So of these three beers that I've had, I'm going to put this as my favourite. Full Hop Alchemist is my second. Got to be careful I drop these beers. And Never Enough Base is my third. In all fairness, West Coast Brewing, they do make some good beers. Make some very, very good beers as well. But definitely they specialise more in the pale ale, the IPAs. If you do get down to 12 in Shizuoka, they've just actually moved, I think, end of February. Definitely could pop in there, try some of their beers. Get down to the tap room though. The tap room's got 16 taps. Yeah, 16 taps at the tap room. All West Coast. Worth a visit. Thank you very much for this little really random 3-day jaunt of beers. I'm going to finish off this Hop Wave. I'm going to pop back inside the log cabin, and then I shall see you next time, hopefully, patrons. Cheers.